For the week of August 15th, 2011, this is the Yokosuka Report on Channel 15, your place for news on the fleet, service members, and our community.
Thousands of people from the Japanese community visited Yokosuka Naval Base to experience the 35th annual Yokosuka Friendship Day Festival. Captain David Owen, the commanding officer of Fleet Activities Yokosuka, said that the event not only helps to strengthen the bond the U.S. has with Japan, but may also help to add some happiness to what has become a difficult year for Japanese citizens.
It's important because it helps strengthen our cooperation and our alliance with the local population, and especially this year with the events that happened earlier with the tsunami and the earthquakes. It's a good opportunity to try to put some smiles back on some people's faces that have had a really rough year and are still trying to recover.
Attendees experience live music, American-style food, ship tours, and many other events and activities throughout the day. Yokosuka Mayor Yuto Yoshida said the festival provides a great venue for the cultural exchange between the two nations.
Each year, we have many visitors, both from within and without the city, to join us for this event. Thanks to Navy Friendship Day, this lively festival has become a great opportunity for Japan-U.S. exchange and a new Yokosuka annual standard.
As the lights went down over the city, those near the waterfront were able to watch a colorful fireworks show over Tokyo Bay presented by Yokosuka City. Petty Officer Bryan, Reckard, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.
Early morning, Yokosuka, Japan. Engines roar and rubber grips road as Chief Damage Controlman Select Robert Lyons rolls in to meet a dream car lined street waiting to enter the 34th annual Yokosuka Friendship Day Car Show.
Well, right now we're lined up along the street on 16 over by the Womble Gate exit, about to ride in for the car show at Friendship Day.
With pistons pumping, Lion leads the pack of more than 60 cars and trucks to display their love of automobiles.
I got a 1932 Ford. I mean, there's no other way to really describe that. I've been working on it for a long time, and I want everyone to get their eyes on it. I thought it'd be a good experience for that to happen.
From muscle to performance, service members along with Japanese nationals gathered to share their bond between man and machine in an open showing of fine-tuned vehicles, each one as unique as the next.
Well, I mean, it's a great day overall. I mean, I love Friendship Day overall. It's a chance for the Japanese nationals to interact, see what's going on, and then to show off their toys as well. So all the car lovers come out here and enjoy themselves.
The celebration over all these moving parts is just a portion of what continues to be a long-standing alliance between the United States and Japan.
It's not about winning. It's just coming out here, having fun, getting to know everybody, and showing off what you got, you know, and It in a sense, you know, builds strong friendships.
Petty Officer Michael Story, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan. Chief Petty Officer Selectees made a special trip to the uniform shop to try on the coveted khaki uniform that they will wear in a few weeks.
It is one of the proudest moments of my life when I first put on my anchors and had them put on, and to this day it's still I still feel that same pride, the same enthusiasm as being a chief. So I enjoy it very much.
Trying on the khakis was an emotional moment for LNC Select Mincy, as she has worked throughout her career to become a chief.
It means a lot to me. I think I've strived my whole career to be the chief. Words can't explain how I feel right now.
For many selectees, wearing the Chief Petty Officer uniform for the first time was difficult to explain.
The first time I tried on, especially the chokers, and I stood in front of the mirror, I was just like, wow, this is, I didn't have any words. I mean, it's surreal. So it feels really, really good.
Petty Officer Chris Henry, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.